Let us now discuss maximum power transfer in a circuit network. Consider a circuit network which is represented by a Thevenin equivalent like this, and that is connected to an external load ZL, and ZL is variable. So this circuit network represented by this Thevenin equivalent is a fixed circuit network, and this can also be represented by a Norton equivalent instead of a Thevenin equivalent. Both are equivalent. So this portion of the circuit network can be represented by a Norton equivalent like this, INR and ZNR, and the external resistance ZL connected across the same two terminals. So these terminals are the output terminals here and here. So when the circuit is connected and ZL is connected across the load terminals, there is power dissipation in this impedance, and there is a power loss in ZL impedance. Likewise, in the case of the Norton equivalent too. And both these power losses will be the same, because the internal circuit, the fixed circuit, is the same for both the equivalents. Now, let us find out at what value of ZL will maximum power be transferred to the ZL load side from the circuit network. Now, this is what we need to know: how much amount of power from the circuit network sources and all sources and the circuit parameters, fixed parameters put together, transfers to the load side circuit, which is ZL. So let us say we have this node named AB, here also node named AB, and a current flowing in the external load as IAB, and likewise here also IAB. Now the power that flows into the load ZL, PZL, is given by IAB square into ZL. And for DC circuits, ZL can be replaced by RL, only resistive, and it reduces to PRL is equal to IAB square into RL. The maximum power transfer theorem states that PRL, the power that is transferred to the load RL, is maximum if RL equals R Thevenin or R Norton. That is, if RL is equal to the driving point impedance of the circuit network, whether it is Thevenin equivalent or the Norton equivalent, then maximum power is transferred to RL. So this is the maximum power transfer theorem. Let us apply maximum power transfer theorem to a circuit network. A DC circuit network is shown like this: 10 volts, 10 ohms, 5 ohms, 1 amp current source, 5 ohms, 10 ohms, and the external output points AB. This is where the external load resistance will be connected. And now this has a Norton equivalent, INR is equal to 1 amp, RNR is equal to 10 ohm. This we have worked out earlier in an earlier example on Norton circuit. Now to this Norton equivalent circuit, let us connect an external load resistance RL like this. And RL is variable. And we need to find out what is the value of RL at which maximum power is transferred to this load resistor. So let us, by maximum power transfer theorem, we should set RL to be equal to 10 ohms, which is the internal resistance of this Norton equivalent, then maximum power is transferred. Let us first take a case where RL is not equal to 10 ohms. So let RL be equal to, let us say, 20 ohms. And IAB is INR, which is 1 amp, into the current that flows through RL. This 1 amp divides into this resistor and into this resistance, and the current division rule is the current through this resistance is the current through the other branch resistor divided by the sum of the resistors. So RNR is the other branch resistance divided by RNR plus RL. So if you work out 1 amp into 10 ohms, which is the other branch resistance, divided by 10 ohms plus 20 ohms. So this is 0.33 amps. And to find out the power PRL is IAB square into RL, which is equal to 0.33 square into 20, will work out to be 2.18 watts. Now take the case when RL is equal to 10 ohms, which is same as the internal impedance of the equivalent circuit, not an equivalent, and therefore the power transfer to the load must be maximum. IAB is 1 amp, just like here, 1 amp to 10 divided by 10 plus 10 ohms, because now this is 10 ohms, which works out to be 0.5 amps. And PRL, power transfer to the load, is 0.5 square into 10, which is 2.5 watts. So this is how you apply the maximum power transfer theorem. Here we have used Norton equivalent circuit, but you can as well use Thevenin equivalent circuit as well.